In this video, we will consider daylight. The main difference between daylight and evening light, morning light and sunset lighting is that we have muted colors at the start and at the end of the day. And there is a fog as well. Daylight doesn't have such effects. Fog is possible though, but mostly it's a clear weather and highly saturated colors, so we won't lower saturation. Again, we start with the sun. The only difference is that the sun will be higher this time. We're starting with the standard layout. Here's our camera. The classical layout is when the sun is at 45 degrees and on the right-hand side. You can actually vary it in the range of 30 degrees. Let's see how it looks like in interactive render. I click on Show Frame Buffer to set right resolution right away. Otherwise, it will be necessary to update render every time you change the buffer size. The geometry is loading, and now we will see the light. The light began to update. We see that our first sun is shining, but second one is not working. The first sun will always be active, and there is only one sun works in Corona. That's why we have to relaunch interactive render. Don't forget that we put fog effect there. In classic daylight scene, there shouldn't be the fog effect. But you can use it though depending on reference and desired result. The sun is too bright now because default settings are too high. We rewrite what we have in settings here just in case. This time, we just lower exposure. Corona Sun works great together with Corona Sky in the default settings. It looks realistic, and it's already a daylight. All we have to do is to move our sun until the satisfying result. It's only a matter of opinion, and you don't have to listen to anyone. Just watch references you like and try to repeat them. There are no specific rules. There are some typical schemes of commercial light setup, but it depends from customer. The key is to make it beautiful. So we will move away from the typical scheme . We set a practically midday light and look at the result. As you can see, this is also interesting solution. These two shadows from trees create additional frame, which separates foreground and background to focus the eye of the viewer on the building. And don't forget that you can set any light you want. You can set completely white color here, and even if you lower your sun, it will remain white. Let's put the sun behind the building. Again, it looks like midday. As you can see, our pieces of grass are far from satisfactory with such light. The ground looks too wet, too reflective. This is an inappropriate layout for the foreground. You need to avoid light like this. And to be able to choose the right one from a wide variety. You can also vary the blur of shadows. For example, the default size value is 1. But here you can do the following. Here we have intensity and size of the sun. The smaller the light source, the clearer the shadows, and vice versa. So, in order to blur the shadows, first thing we need to do is to place the sun according to classic scheme. As I said earlier, daylight is different from morning and evening in that it has bright colors. So, we reset saturation. Now it looks natural. You can also lower contrast a bit and increase filmic shadows. Since the midday sun gives very bright light, areas with no shadows will be overexposed. The brighter these areas are, the darker will be the shadows. By the rule of exhibiting, shadows in this area will be darker. So, the brighter is the sun, the closer the sun to the afternoon, the darker are the shadows. You can also see the example of this effect on my work. There is a bright sun, maximum bright light spots, and maximum dark shadows. This contrast makes the picture voluminous in the first place. We can set the minimum value of the size, which is 1/10. But it's enough to set value of 1. The default value already gives clear shadows. But in order to make these shadows blurry, we will increase these values. 5 times higher than original, there is no big difference. But when we increase it some more, shadows will start to blur. The maximum possible size of the sun is 64. There is a feeling that sun passes through clouds, through cloudy sky, and that's why our shadows fade. They become brighter. Let's increase it a bit more. Set practically maximum value. Now we see that blur is getting stronger, and this light starts to look like a cloudy weather rather than sunny weather. It's also an interesting effect. You can also put some object in front of your sun, projecting a shadow from the object on the building, some roads, ground, or something else. This shadow will blur, take a rounded shape, and eventually look like a shadow from the cloud. The maximum value is 64. This time we choose HDRI. First, we click on any of HDRI icons, and we see a preview of it. Every of these files waits a lot, and 3ds Max loads a preview too long. We'll make it easier. We will look at it through a directory. Just open PDF file. There is also a preview in it. So, here is the third compilation. We see the first HDRI and what it represents. Thus, we have a sun coming through the clouds, a cold evening lighting. Here is also a low sun. We'll be probably choosing 7th option. It looks cleaner. We're choosing 7th or 10th. The map is loaded. Just in case, always check that there is a spherical mode. It's set by default. So, we load Corona Color Correct as usual. We will rule our HDRI through Corona Correct if needed. Now, we put it on Use Corona slot and watch the result. Current exposure value is too low. So, we need to either increase it right here or... What's the difference? I'll give you the advice. If your light sources have already been set and you don't want to increase them, then don't touch the exposure setting. Balance of those light sources and their influence on other illuminated objects. You just change settings here through Color Correct. To do that, you simply increase exposure. It works well, as you see. With this light in camera position, we make our vignette lower. And increase exposure some more. Now our picture looks flat. Because we have very few shadows, and light shines from somewhere here, creating flat shadows. We need more shadows and more expression. Yes, the sun is shining from somewhere here. You can tell by the shadows over there. It's nearly noon. Let's try to rotate our map. If it's not enough horizontally, we will rotate it vertically. Shadows don't have enough contrast. I can increase the overall contrast, but the downside is that the contrast is increasing everywhere. Filmic shadows also help to add some contrast. We also lower gamma of our HDRI through Color Correct to make the light as bright as possible. It works well, but at the same time, we should lower exposure. We lowered it too much. Let's raise it back. Our HDRI got a not-so-natural yellowness. And this contradicts the common understanding of daylight. Corona Correct is a powerful tool, so we just lower saturation a bit. The whole picture, including shadows, keeps its contrast, and we get rid of that yellow light. I don't like the position of the sky in this case. HDRI creates beautiful sky. So, we can just copy it. We can even highlight and copy our map by pressing Shift-Control. Then, put it in Direct Visibility Override. We also have HDRI left from last time. We can use it for the sky. We use these people. Wait for upload. This time, light stays in one place. And we move the position of the visible sky dome with the override, with the map. We must also consider that approximate position of the sun must match the sky to avoid the situation when the sun is behind the camera and the sun disk is over here. It can't be there if the sun is already behind us. So let's start from zero. That's much better, but we'll try to lower it to a negative value. It's also possible, but I want to raise the horizon. If you still want to replace the background in Photoshop, best way to do it is to light up your scene in any way and set black color in Direct Visibility Override. So you need to disable the current map, or maybe there will be no map at all. A picture with a tuned light will upload correctly, but there will be no background. This is mostly useful when you deal with the edges. I'll show you how to get rid of the halo, which appears on the edges during the post-processing. However, by turning on the black color in Visibility Override, you can solve this problem right away.